Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video. This time, since I'm working on an infrared time-lapse movie, I want to edit a single frame of this movie, which will be a lot of fun. So let's get started. By the way, you can see I'm in the camera raw editor to do the basic raw adjustments. And before we start any editing, the most important thing is to change the profile. You can see I have created a custom profile for this. And that's because for infrared images, you have to adjust the white balance very precisely to get the desired look. Right now you can see the white balance temperature is at 50,000, which is normally not possible with the other profiles. Then I'm just picking up the white balance tool and click in an area which is supposed to be white, for example, the clouds in the sky. And I'm aiming for a slightly yellow color cast in the blue of the sky while the foreground has this slightly aqua color tone. So this actually looks pretty decent already, but let's see if we can find a better spot. That should look good. When we are taking a look at the histogram, you can see we do have a pretty nice exposure already. We do have some room left on both sides. That means we can nicely push the contrast. And this way we are just spreading the histogram. We can further boost this effect, of course, by increasing the whites. So the histogram goes more to the right side. And by bringing down the blacks, we are spreading the histogram more towards the left side. And this way we have added some nice contrast. Now I do want to drop the highlights slightly so we get more details in those clouds up there. And finally, let's also boost the saturation so we later have some nice colors in here. Okay, now of course you might be wondering why the colors look this strange. This will be fixed in a later step in Photoshop. For now, I aim to get a yellowish color tone in the blue part of the sky, which will later be actually blue. And for the foreground, I want to have this cyan blue color tone, which will later be some kind of pink color tone. So let's work on the sky so we can get a deep blue sky later in Photoshop. For this reason, I have applied this gradiated filter outside the image, which just means it's affecting the whole image. I want to specifically target the dark parts of the sky, so I'm creating a luminance range mask. Now let's check this box to visualize the luminance map. And since we are targeting the dark parts, I'm filtering out the bright areas just like that by bringing the slider down. Now you can see we have a pretty nice selection for the dark part of the sky. And with this gradiated filter, now I simply boost the temperature to make this area warmer. Nice. Now to further work on the sky, I'm using this gradiated filter and I just want to introduce some more clarity to make those clouds look amazing. Okay. And then finally for the foreground, I want to have some stronger cyan color tones, so I am using this gradiated filter to drop the temperature. And that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's do a little bit of color grading in the color mixer tab. Actually, there isn't much going on. I'm just boosting the aqua hue a little bit, which will just affect the foreground. And this way I get a really nice pink color tone later. All right, then let's sharpen this shot. And now we can finish the editing in Photoshop. So first, let's get the colors right. To do this, I'm going to apply a channel mixer adjustment layer. And in the red output channel, I'm dropping red to 0 while I'm increasing blue to 100. And let's then switch over to the blue channel. And here I'm doing the opposite thing. I'm increasing red to 100 and I'm dropping blue to 0. And here we have the classic infrared look. Now I'm personally not a fan of this strange color tone in the sky, so I want to fix that real quick using a hue and saturation adjustment layer. And for the color we want to choose cyans. And just turn up the hue a little bit until we get this nice blue color tone. Alright, that looks great. Then we can also adjust the reds a bit, just boosting the saturation here. Nice. And now we're pretty much done already, I guess. There are still a few objects I want to remove, and therefore I'm using the spot healing brush. And let's get rid of a few things here. Some sensor spots up there. And I also want to close the gaps in the clouds right there, because it's kind of distracting. And up here as well. Let's close this big gap on the left side, and then I think we're finished. Alright, that looks pretty nice. So I hope this was an interesting video. If you have any questions about the editing, let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.